Well, welcome to Jazz Vespers here at St. Andrews-Wesley. My name is Gary Paterson, and I'm one of the ministers here. You can see behind me at the backdrop a picture of our sanctuary, the place where we belong and the place where we will eventually return. It's hard to imagine and to do Jazz Vespers online, but it's the best we have right now to keep connected and in touch and to allow the uniqueness of Jazz Vespers to shine. Jazz Vespers brings some of the very best musicians of Vancouver into a time where they can offer their gifts and their musical ability. Today we are having with us Kristian Alexandrov, who has deep roots in Bulgaria, but has been playing in Canada for 35 years, an excellent percussionist and pianist, and a composer as well. And with him, who has been his partner for so many years in this musical enterprise, is Shannon Gaye, with deep roots in central BC, and now here in Vancouver, a big, beautiful, loud, sultry voice. Soulful is the word that I often hear in reference to Shannon. And the two of them will be putting together their music interspersed with reflections or poetry or stories or meditation, so that it is not just music or a concert, but becomes another exploration of the mystery where jazz and the spirit dance together and we are taken one more step along our journey. In a moment, you are going to see Kristian actually speak to you and say, these are crazy times, and we need each of us to have a little bit of faith. And from there, he flows into his own composition entitled, of course, Prayer. And I want you to just watch and see how the opening almost feels like a sunrise. There is melancholy and there is joy mingled together, an openness of the chords that go up and down, repeat, and take you on a spiritual journey. Watch for the very end where we finish with deep, deep notes and then a ripple conclusion. And to know that this is a time for us to be vulnerable, to be open to the Spirit, to let our prayers of thanksgiving or deep concern rise to whomever, to whatever, maybe just mindfulness and stillness, or maybe we thank you, God, for most this amazing day, for the leaping greenly spirits of trees, for a true blue dream of sky, for everything which is natural, which is infinite, which is yes, well, which is jazz. So listen and be taken on a prayerful journey. Here we go, prayer.
These are crazy times, and we all need a little faith. I wanted to share a composition of mine called Prayer.
Today's music takes us on our spiritual journey, moving out of that soulful prayer, and now into an original composition by Kristian and Shannon entitled, I Got This, which is an affirmation of life and hope in the midst of pandemic or in the midst of loss or in the midst of any of the challenges. And you'll feel the resilience that comes in the very act of offering this song in the face of so many challenges. The song has energy, it even has bounce, it has a sense of laughter, and yet the chorus says it almost knocked me, it really got the best of me, it really knocked me off my feet, head underwater, can't make a sound, trying to find the surface, got lost in the deep for a little while, yet I believe I got this, I know I got this, everything's going to be all right, everything will be fine, and what a reassurance that we need, and you can feel it not only in the words, but in the very energy of the music, and I found myself wondering, where does this faith come from? Is it hope? Is it deep-rooted determination and conviction? Is it an expression of hard-earned experience? Or is it some deeper faith that connects to the reality, to the mystery that sustains all of us? I found myself thinking of Psalm 121. Oh, I lift up mine eyes into the hills. From whence cometh my help? The help cometh from God who made heaven and earth. The Holy One will not let thy foot be moved. The one who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, the one who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord will keep your life. The Lord is thy shade on thy right hand, and the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. No, the Lord will keep you from all evil. The Lord will keep your life. The Lord will keep your coming in and your going out from this time forth, yea, and forevermore. So we got this, and God has got this. And the Spirit, however you understand that mystery, has got this. And each one of us, we can tap into strength of faith or of family or of friends or our own deepest being, and we will be able to feel and to believe we got this. Everything will be all right. I got this.
But it keeps me honest. See, there's this moment of regret, and every single night I dream it's the final scene. Yeah, it almost got the best of me, nearly knocked me off my feet. Head underwater, can't make a sound. Trying to find the surface, got a little lost in the deep. I got this. Yeah, I know I got this. I got this. Habit I can't break. You don't need to worry about it. When I'm alone, I laugh out loud. The fact is, I've made the odd mistake. Everybody stumbles, it's really only natural. Yeah, it almost got the best of me, really knocked me off my feet. Head underwater, can't make a sound. Trying to find the surface, got a little lost in the deep. But I do believe I got this. It's gonna be alright, and everything will work out fine. Just gotta give it some time. Yeah, it almost got the best of me, really knocked me off my feet. I got this burning in my chest just to remind me when it's time to breathe.
So do you feel it in your bones that you got this? You start with prayer and openness and then this deep reassurance that everything will be fine. And then we move now into another original composition, Balkan Sky, an invitation into a sense of wonder and mystery and an openness. Watch the particular fusion of percussion and voice and drum. The piano starts off and opens us up. The voice of Shannon will move in and go up and down. You can sense the joy, you can sense the sorrow. You know that this is an invitation into experiencing the deepest realities of life, this Balkan sky, this sky that stretches over all of us and that holds us together. It reminded me of a poem by Mary Oliver called The Invitation. And she writes, she says, she pleads, "Do you have any time to linger? Just for a little while, out of your busy and very important life, to linger for the goldfinches who have gathered in this field of thistles for a musical battle to see who can sing the highest note or the lowest, the most expressive of mirth or the most tender. Their strong, blunt beaks drink into the air as they strive melodiously, not for your sake and not for mine, and certainly not for the sake of winning, but for sheer gratitude and delight. Believe us, they say, it is a serious thing to be alive on this fresh morning in the broken world. I pray that you do not pass by, but that you pause to attend to this rather ridiculous performance. It might mean something. It might mean everything. It might be what the German poet Rilke meant when he wrote, you must change your life. So enter into a Balkan sky. Hear it as an invitation to linger, to savor, and to know the delight that is all around, and hear it expressed in this beautiful composition, Balkan Sky.
Thank you.
So we begin with prayer and we move into I Got This with the sense of resilience and confidence, and then into the wonder and possibility of the Balkan sky. But now we come to a harder and harsher reality. It is a classic breakup song, Bullet Hit the Bone. And there are some hard parts of Let Me Just Have It, You're Halfway Out the Door, Don't Beat Around the Bush. There is, however, a willingness to lift up the memories of love, that what we had was real and is to be cherished and was wonderful. And now the time has come to change. And so the singer asks for honesty. Don't try to let me down gently. Let me hear the truth, which is what I think we all need. We need the truth, we need the memories, and we then need to move on and find new hope. But this song challenges us to recognize the full reality of loss, of what it means to be a human being. And you can hear it in the actual lyrics, you can hear it in the tempo of the tune, you can hear it at the almost abrupt ending. And it comes to us as a recognition that it's not just lovers who sometimes get hit or that need to take that loss in, but it can be the loss we experience of a child, a parent, a dear friend, our work, our home. So many things come into us as vulnerable, fragile humans, and we rely on the memories and the trust and hope of love and the faith in a mystery that holds us all. I recall yet another poem by Mary Oliver that she entitled At Black Water Pond. And she says, look, the trees are turning themselves into pillars of light, and they're giving off the rich fragrance of cinnamon and fulfillment. The long cattail tapers are bursting and floating over the blue shoulders of the ponds, and every pond, no matter what its name, is nameless now. Every year, everything I have learned in my life brings me to the same place, the fires and the dark river of loss, whose other side is salvation, whose meaning we shall never know. To live in this world, you must be able to do three things: to love what is mortal, to hold it against your bones, knowing your life depends upon it, and when the time comes to let it go, to let it go. So, bullet hits the bone. Love what is mortal. Hold it against your bones, knowing your life depends upon it. And when the time of loss, when the time of saying goodbye and surrendering comes to you in whatever time and ever space, then let it go, then let it go. So listen carefully. Bullet hits the bone.
Between us, even try to break the fall. Cause if you really wanna go your own way, let the bullet hit the bone. We've been living on the edge for some time now, and we both know.
Just before we come into our final song, maybe this is a moment to say, to invite, if you like what's happening here at Jazz Vespers, you might feel called to make a donation to enable this program, this worship, this Vespers, this music and reflection to continue on. So go to the St. Andrews-Wesley website, find the donate button, click on that, and then the rest just happens automatically, it seems. But I am very interested in this last song, If I Ain't Got You. It's a cover of a song written by Alice Keys that arose for her from a time of sorrow and loss and where there was struggle and tragedy all around, and trying to discover what sustains us in those difficult times. It's not particularly written as a pandemic song, but it works that way. I can survive almost anything if I got you, but if I ain't got you, baby, then there's nothing. And of course, this is a song of romance, but it is also a song of friendship or of family or of collegiality or community. It could, I believe, actually be a song about the spirit, about the mystery, the one we would call God, the holy. If I ain't got you, baby, and who is this you that is being talked about? Think of it in the broadest sense possible, because it is an affirmation that it is love that holds us at the root of everything. In challenging times, both our own personal loss or what we are going through as a society with the COVID virus, well, we need to trust, to have faith and hope, but above all, we need to love each other. So often you might remember that we finish our Jazz Vesper service in the sanctuary where we will eventually end up. And I say something like this to you, Life is short, my friends, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those we travel with. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. Be swift to love and make haste to be kind. Perhaps especially in pandemic times, but always, day by day, in the face of loss, there is love, and we can hold it together and thrive and find joy. If I ain't got you, baby.
Some people live for a fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think that the physical thing define what's within, and I've been there before, but that life's a bore, so full of a superficial. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I ain't got you, baby. Some people want diamond rings, some just want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you, yeah. Some people search for a fountain that promises forever young. Some people need 3 dozen roses, and that's the only way to prove you love them. Hand me the world on a silver platter, and what good would it be? No one to share, and no one who truly cares for me. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing.